ஆண்டாள் திருவடிகளே சரணம். திருப்பாவை 29th பாசுரம். சிற்றம் சிறுகாலே வந்துன்னை சேவித்து உன் பொற்றா மறையடியே போற்றும் பொருள் கேளாய். பெற்றம் மேய்த்துண்ணும் குலத்தில் பிறந்து நீ குற்றே வலங்களை கொள்ளாமல் போகாது. இற்றை பறை கொள்வான் அன்று காண் கோவிந்தா. எற்றைக்கும் ஏழேழ் பிறவிக்கும் உந்தன்னோடு உற்றோமேயாவோம். உனக்கே நாமாட்செய்வோம் மற்ற நங்காமங்கள் மாற்றேலோரெம்பாவாய். ஆண்டாள் அண்ட் ஹர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் ஸ்பீக்கிங் டு த லார்ட் நவ் அபவுட் வாட் தே வாண்ட் டு கெட் ஃப்ரம் ஹிம் ஸோ தட் தே கேன் கம்ப்ளீட் தேர் பாவை நோம்பு. அண்ட் த லார்ட் இஸ் ஆல்சோ வெரி பேஷண்ட்லி லிஸ்னிங் டு தெம். அண்ட் ஹீ ஹேட் அ க்வெஸ்சன் இன் த ப்ரீவியஸ் பாசுரம் வேர் ஹீ ஆஸ்ட் வெதர் தி கேர்ள்ஸ் ஹேட் தி எலிஜிபிலிட்டி டு ஆஸ்க் ஸோ மச் ஃப்ரம் ஹிம். To which the girls replied that they did not have the eligibility, but not being eligible itself was an eligibility because they bore an eternal relationship with the Lord, and because of this relationship the Lord was bound to save them since they had asked for protection. So the girls said that undannod uravel namakking olikka oliyadu. The relationship between you and us is eternal, O Lord. It can never be destroyed. Listening to this beautiful sentence of wisdom, the Lord is thoroughly impressed and he decides to grant everything that the girls have asked for. And accordingly, he calls out to his servants nearby and tells them to go and get what the girls have asked for. We have to understand the scene here. The Lord is seated on his royal throne in his royal chamber, and there are some servants standing beside him, and the girls are standing in front of him talking to him. And listening to these beautiful words of these girls, the Lord calls out to his servants and say, I have decided to grant everything to these girls, so now go and bring all the items that they have enlisted. But in the beginning, the first thing I want you all to get is, go and get this parai drum that they have been asking for, because this parai is the thing that they have been asking since the first pasuram. They said narayanane namakke parai taruvan in the first pasuram, and so on. They have been talking about parai all through. So let me grant them this parai first, this drum first. So go and fetch drums for all these girls. So as the Lord gives this instruction, these servants, they hurry up and they come out with drums in their hands. And beautifully decorated drums are all present there. And the Lord presents them to the girls and says, you all wanted parai all the while. Come on, take this parai. Listening to this statement of the Lord, Aandaal talks out in full emotion to him. She says, O Lord, we have come here early in the morning. At the wee hours of dawn, we have come all the way to you. Sitram sirugale vandunnai chevithu. Sitram sirugale refers to very early dawn. That is about 3 to 4:30 a.m. in the morning. We have woken up so early and come all the way to you. Vandunnai chevithu. We have come and we are bowing down to you at this early hour of dawn. And let me tell you, O Lord, we are girls who have been really pampered and brought up by our parents. We are not used to getting up in early morning hours. We in fact take up two blankets and nicely sleep in the winter months. So we really are not used to getting up so early and coming outside in this cold. But we have come all the way to you. And having come here, what are we doing? உன் பொற்றா மறையடியே போற்றும் பொருள் கேளாய். We are singing the glory of your golden lotus-like feet. உன் பொற்றா மறையடியே. பொற்றா மறை refers to the golden lotus. The feet of the Lord are as beautiful as the lotus. But the lotus flower can wither away after a while. So, if a lotus flower were made of gold, it would remain with that beauty forever. So also are the Lord's feet, so beautiful as the golden lotus. So we are singing the glory of these lotus feet. She did sing in the 24th Pasuram when she said, Andravulagamalandayadi potri. So we are singing the glory of your feet. We have been singing your glory all along the way when we came to your palace too. And you should understand the reason behind such an act of ours, of coming early in the morning and singing the glory of your feet. Do you think we have done this act just for this parai, this drum that you're giving us? It's true that we have been asking you all the while for parai, parai, parai. But, O Lord, please think and try to recollect as to all those hidden messages we have been keeping in the previous pasurams. Didn't we tell you in the 23rd Pasuram that you must actually go deep into our words, analyze and then grant us boons. Araindarulelo rembavai. We said that araindarul. Please analyze before you grant. Not only that, in the 25th Pasuram, what did we say? We said unnayaruthithu vandom. We have come to you, O Lord. Unnai aruthithu vando means we have come to you and we have come for you. So it is you for whom we have come, not to get anything of you. So the Lord is again confused. What is this y'all are saying? Y'all have been enlisting things that you want of me. And now you are saying that you don't want anything from me, but you want me. I don't understand. So the girls laugh and say, yes, we understand why you don't understand. Because you have also come in this clan of cowherds. Petrammei tunnum kulathil pirandu. You have come in this kulam, clan, which is used to eating only after feeding cows. Petrammei tunnum kulam, she says. That means that the cowherds follow dharma to such an extent that they ensure that their cows are well fed before they have food themselves. So you have come in this clan of cowherds, and we have also come in the same clan of cowherds as Gopikas. And how is our clan? I just described in the Pasuram before. How is it? Arivondrumillada aikulathu. It is Arivondrumillada aikulam. We don't think much. We don't have too much of IQ. So, obviously, though I have been telling you to analyze and reason out and giving you hidden messages all the while, you have apparently not understood. And what you have not understood is Kutre valengalai kollamal pogadu itrai parai kolvan andru. We do not want this materialistic drum parai. Itrai parai kolvan andru. We don't want this drum or anything materialistic that we have asked for. What do we want? Kutre valengalai kollamal pogadu. You have to choose and ordain us for doing service. That is what we expect of you. We wish to be at your beck and call for your service. That is all that we want. We don't want this parai. So the Lord is like, why then have you been asking me for parai and not only parai, but so many other things? They say, the girls say, that see Lord, we have tried to make a setup that we are performing this Margari Nombu or Pavai Vratam. And so the people around, the society around should believe that we are doing something that what ancestors have done. Melayar Seivanagal, as we said. So, all these things are required for performing the Pavai Nombu. So we asked that we need all these things. But you need to please understand that every time we asked for any particular thing, our hidden meaning or agenda was only you. Because if you just remember what we said Sala Perum Paraye, and we said Kola Vilakke, Kodiye, Vidaname. These were all the things we enlisted in the 26th Pasuram. For every word they have used, A means we need only that. We need only Salaperumbarai. We need only Pallandi Saippar. We need only Kola Vilakku and so on. When we said only, what we actually meant was we only need you as our Salaperumbarai. We only need you as our Kola Vilakku. We only need you as our Vidhanam. So you are everything for us. You are our Parai. You are our Kola Vilakku. You are our Vidhanam. Similarly, in the next Pasuram, in the 27th Pasuram, when we said, Sudagame, Tolvalaye, Tode, Sevipuve, we asked for all those ornaments. We said, we want the hair accessory, Sudagam. What we actually meant was, we wanted only you, because you are our hair accessory, you are our anklet, you are actually the Bhushan or accessory that we can wear. Your name on our lips is accessory to us. Your thought in our mind is accessory to us. So it is only you that we have been praying for, O Lord, all this while. So though we enlisted all these things in the understanding of the common man, they would seem like things. But you, O Lord, must understand that our internal intention was nothing but having you as everything. So we only wish to have you and your service, O Lord, says Andal. And here again, she addresses the Lord as Govinda, itrai parai kolvan, anrukan Govinda. O Lord, we really understand that you have not understood our internal intention only because you are Govinda the cowherd. So being Govinda the cowherd, you have chosen to remain as the cowherd only, who doesn't want to get deep into analysis and just understand the meaning from the face of it. So, the Lord is being very fondly called as Govinda by Andal here. Now, we need to understand one thing, that this is a hat trick of Govindas. The name Govinda has come 3 times in the Pasurams 27, 28 and 29. There are 2 other names which appear thrice in the ThiruppAvai. They are Narayana. The word Narayana has been uttered by Andal 3 times in the first 10 verses. First in the first verse, then in the 7th verse, and again in the 10th verse. Similarly, the mention of Lord Trivikrama has come 3 times in the ThiruppAvai. And this mention of Trivikrama has been distributed over the 3 decades of ThiruppAvai. She mentions Trivikrama once in the 3rd Pasuram, which comes in the first 10 verses. Again, she mentions Trivikrama in the 17th verse, which comes in the second 10. And then she mentions Trivikrama in the 24th verse, which comes in the third 10. Govinda, which is the most special name, she has chosen to keep in the last so that it gets highlighted completely. And she has kept them together in 3 verses such that it appears as a hat trick. So the hat trick of Govindas, she calls out Govinda for the 3rd time here and says, O Lord, it seems that you have really stopped thinking and analyzing because you are Govinda. And so now let me clearly word what we want. I will also not talk in hidden language anymore. Let me exactly tell you what we want. What do they want now? Yetraikum yezhel piravikum undannodu utromeyavom unakke namaacheyvom. We want to always be in your service. Nam aacheyvom, that is, we want to serve you. And how do we want to serve you? When do we want to serve you? Yetraikum yezhel piravikum. We want to serve you everywhere, at every point, at every time. Yezhel piravikum. Even if we keep on having eternal number of births, we want to serve you. Now here a question arises, that having so much of wisdom and so much of interest in service, will the Lord let these girls take rebirths again and again? They are surrendering to Him. So He will take them into eternal service, isn't it? So why is Andal talking about births, piravi here? So the commentators very beautifully clarify that here, births refers to the avatars of the Lord, the birth of the Lord as avatars. So Andal is saying that how many ever avatars you take, we also wish to come down and serve you in each of those avataras. So she's talking about the avataras of the Lord. So whenever He incarnates, wherever He incarnates, she wants to serve Him. she, not only she, but also her friends, all these girls, they want to serve him. Yetraikum, yeel piravikum, undan nod, utromeyavum, we always want to be in association with you and serve you. Unakke nama cheyvom, serve only you. Unakke, she's saying. We want to serve only you because you are everything to us. Nama cheyvom. And in case this intention of ours gets changed due to something, please, please, please take care to change our minds back to this virtue. Matrai nanka mangal matre lorembavai. Today we have the good sense to ask you for eternal service. Tomorrow, because of our sins, if we tend to think otherwise, please, Lord, change our mind back to this virtuous state. Matrai nanka mangal matre lorembavai. We should not have any other desire other than serving you, O Lord. If we think of anything else, please change it. Now here, commentators give a more beautiful meaning to this particular phrase. Matrai nam kamangal matru. Andal is saying nam kamangal means our desires. So she is saying, please change our desires. In the sense, please change your desire and my desire if they are against this virtuous state of mind, this state of mind of doing service. Now, why is she saying that? She's saying because she doesn't want herself to change, and it seems she doesn't want the Lord also to change his mind for their sake. Means what? Means sometimes when we try to serve the Lord, we try to serve him in a way that pleases us. Means we may think that today the Lord may like sweet porridge as an offering, and we may make sweet porridge and give it. But actually, the Lord in his mind would probably think that he wanted something else today. Probably he wanted tamarind rice today as an offering. But he will graciously accept anything that a devotee offers because he loves his devotees. But Andal says she doesn't want that. She wants to serve the Lord in a way which pleases the Lord. Means she wants to serve his interest, his personal interest. She doesn't want him to change himself for their sake, as it is his natural behavior to give in everything for the devotees and to accept anything that the devotee gives. So Andal is saying that please do not accept anything for my sake. You ask what you want from me and I will do it. This is what is called as Pritikarita Kainkaryam. Means doing service that pleases the Lord. The Lord will be pleased with any service we do. But there is something that he has as personal pleasure. So a true devotee will like to do what the Lord personally likes. And so Andal is saying that please let me know what you like, and I would like to do only that for your sake. Don't see my convenience or my liking, and don't try to adjust for my sake. Just give me orders for your pleasure, and I will stand and do my duty and service to you with all pleasure of heart. Such is the kind of service mind that Andal prays for. And by saying parai 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 all this while, she only meant doing divine service at his holy feet all the while. She did not know anything other than the Lord, and she did not want anything other than the service of the Lord. And that is what she has very beautifully clarified in this penultimate pasuram of the ThiruppAvai. And with this, she has finished conversing with the Lord. And so the Pavai Nombu also has come to an end, because the end of the Pavai Nombu was getting the Lord's divine service. And so, though she asked him for so many things, all of that actually was only the Lord himself and his divine service. So when she mentioned to the Lord clearly that it's divine service that she wanted, the Lord grants it to her. And with this, the Pavai Nombu comes to an end. In the last pasuram of the ThiruppAvai, Andal tells us the benefits that we will get by reciting the ThiruppAvai, and the background from which she has come and composed the ThiruppAvai. So it is called as the Phalashruti Pasuram, and that we shall enjoy tomorrow.